All right, guys, we back on the 2006 Polaris 700 Sportsman here. My last video, I replaced the bushings that went down in the handlebar rod and the bearings in the bottom where the tie rod's ends are. Because I was having a problem about shaking the front end, shaking it at higher speeds. That didn't solve my problem. It took a little bit of it out, but it didn't solve all the shaking problems. So today I'm gonna replace the ball joints on both sides and the bushings for the A arm and see if that helps me out. So first thing I need to do, I need to jack this four wheeler up and get the tires off of it. I'm gonna try to jack it up high as I can for you guys can actually see under the bottom where I'm working at to get those ball joints off. So let me get started on that, and we'll come back when I get it jacked up and the wheels off. Okay, we on the right side of the ATV here. We're gonna try to get this A arm loose here from the bottom of this ball joint. So we gotta remove a collet pin right here. It's a little small one. It shouldn't be too difficult here. Okay, we got the right socket now. All right, now we want to try to get that loose. The best way I've found, if I can find my small hammer here, is to just hit on the side of the A-arm here. Just tap on the either side of it. Just to try to get it to get loose here. And then I'm going to hit it with my my dead blow hammer so that I can, because right now it's down at the bottom of its travel and I need to get it up some to before I can have some room to knock it down. So let me get my jack set up on it and get some pressure off of that. Okay, I got my my jack up on the here on the hub where the tires go to get some pressure off of that A arm and see if I can get it to let go here. And it's getting it more at a level angle instead of tilted down and putting pressure on that ball joint. There we go. Like I said, if the hammer don't work, get you a bigger hammer. It always gives up. So I'm gonna lower this down before I can get it out of my way and just let it hang here. Move that jack out the way. Okay, now we got that off, we can go about getting the bolts off the bottom side. The bottom side like we did with the one that I took off on the left side. Okay, just to let you guys see the bottom of where the ball joint is, I had to take this spindle housing off the left side of my ATV because I'm going to replace the bearing in here. The bearing is needs to be replaced. I think that's probably a lot of my wobbling of the front tire when I'm getting up to a higher speed. But we're going to go ahead and replace the ball joints because I have them, and the bushings because I have them. So what I did was I got my Allen wrench here, and I'm just trying to see if it's a number on it for the size, but I don't see one. Yes, I do. It's 5/32. And what I did was, they on there pretty tight. I sprayed it with some WD-40 first, if you got some PB Blast or something. Then I just got something I could put over here before I can get some leverage without it hurting my hand. They did break loose, so I'm going to just take these out. And both of them, I already broke both of them loose. We're going to take these out and see how we can get that ball joint out of the bottom of this housing here. So let's see if we can get those bolts off and get this rubber boot out the way. And like I said, I got my trusty little hand tool here. I need to set that up again. Different angle here. Okay, we got that loose. Let's see if we can get the other side. And that came loose pretty good. So now we can take these bolts loose. Well, they're not bolts, they're screws, but you know what I mean. All right, we got those two off. We'll get the plate off. Now we need our setup to pull that bearing out. Okay, we got the screws out, and this plate was just sitting on there. It actually holds the ball joint inside that housing. Well, when you take it out, I mean, if yours is stuck on there or something, you probably get a hammer or with a nail or chisel or something to knock it sideways to get it to move. But there is a special tool that goes over here and actually pulls this ball joint out. But of course, I don't have that tool. So what I have elected to do is I got a piece of an old bearing, one side of a bearing that, like I said, if this is a bearing, this is not the one it came out of, but it's the back side of the bearing. And I'm going to put that over top of this. As you can see, it's bigger than the ball joint. Then I'm going to get a couple of big washers to go over for to sit on the rim of this bearing little housing. And I'm just going to step up with the washers before I can get it small enough and thick enough for when I tighten down on that, it pulls that ball joint out of the socket. And so I'm going to put some smaller washers here because the bolt actually that goes on here is actually small in size. So I'm just going to put about that many washers on. Then I'm going to screw the nut on here. So hopefully I can get that to move without it twisting inside and messing up this nut. I mean, the ball joint threads I don't care about, but I don't think the new ball joints came with a new nut. So that is a 14 millimeter nut there. I'm gonna get my impact wrench, socket deal here. And we're gonna try and see if we can get that bearing to actually move. Let's see if it. Let's see if we actually got to move any. Yeah, see, as you can see, it's starting to come out. That's exactly what we want. So we're going to keep on doing that and get this ball joint out before we can put the new one in. Okay, as you can see, we got the ball joint out. We did have to put another spacer on here to get that ball joint to come all the way out. So, you know, the further that ball joint comes out of that hole, the taller it needs to be. So I did get two of these spacers to get that ball joint to finally come out. Now I just got to get this nut out because the inside of this ball joint spins, and I just need something to hold this back of this shaft here just to get this bolt off. Then we'll put the new one inside. Okay, hopefully you can see this. We got the bearing little housing on here with three washers and a couple little smaller ones. See if we can get that ball joint to start pulling out of there. I got my impact on it, and see if we can. All right, let's see if we can see if that's moved. All right, we can see it's starting to pull out. If you can see up under there, it's out probably a quarter of an inch. Okay, now that we got that moving, we're going to have to use both of these bearing little cups here. And we're going to try to see if we can get that all the way out. So we're going to have to use both bearing backing cups, whatever you want to call it. I'm just going to call it a bearing cup. A smaller washer, and we're just going to put the nut back on there and see if we can get that to pull all the way out. It's hard to get the screw to start because the shaft is spinning. So you have to pull it a little bit sideways to put it in a little bind to get it started. Okay, now that we got that on there, we're going to put my noisy impact on. Then we're going to make sure it's going the right way. Sorry. And now it came out. So like I said, we got the bearing, the washer still on it. Now I gotta just get something, a pair of pliers or something to hold that to get this nut off of it. Then we can see if we can get the new one to go in. Okay, we got that off. Now I'm just trying to just test fit the new one where the old ball joint was, and it just seems like it just doesn't want to go in there. The old one, well, not the old one, but the other side, like I said, I got my Dremel tool and I ran in the inside of it a couple of times to actually remove a little of the material to actually get this started in there. And I think I'm going to do the same thing here because I'm going to use the tap-in method. And it's not going to go in there straight. And when I tap it in there, it's just going to deform the inside of that housing anyway. So I can go in there with the Dremel inside, or I can go with the Dremel on the outside of this, which might be the smartest thing to do. If I'm gonna move some, remove some material, just to remove the material on the actual ball joint. That way, if I do anything detrimental to it, I hadn't messed the inside of this housing up. Just all I messed up was a ball joint, which I can go get another ball joint. So let me get my Dremel connected up, and let's remove just a little bit of this material around here to get this thing started inside that cup area right here. Like I said, this is not the preferred method. It's just this is just my method. I mean, these are aftermarket ball joints, so you know they might not be just the spec. Okay, they want to start a little bit better, but they're not good enough yet. And this is like some hardened steel, so it's not removing material as well as I would like. So what I am going to do, I'm going inside the housing over here to just remove just a little bit of material when it first start going up in there. I'm just going to get some WD-40 in there to lube it up and try to get some of them shavings out of there. Just trying to clean some of the shavings out of here. And try to fit this ball joint back in here. Okay, that's got it started. And I'm gonna try to give it a couple of love taps and see if I can't get it to go in that kind of straight. Like I said, I'm just barely tapping on it. And look at it, make sure it's going in that straight. Just want to get some WD-40 to help it. See if I can get it lubed up a little more to help it going up in there. Just looks like the back end is not going in there as straight as I like it. That's why I'm trying to angle this to the back something. It's not helping that this is moving, but like I said, it just went in real good that time, so it's almost in there. Okay, there it goes. It bottomed out then. Like I said, you can get the retaining plate. Just put it on there and see if it's flush, which it is. So we got the ball joint in there now. So we can go clean up our little retaining housing here, little clip. And we can put it back on. And like I said, with the screws, put some blue Loctite on them if you got it. And we'll get that installed and we'll be done with that. Then we can go